This conference will now be recorded.
Similarly, like our SQL, we have Oracle database also. It's not only Oracle database. If you have any database like Hadoop or HANA or MySQL or any other database, if you want to be connect, just find out the relevant package which is helping you to connect your Python to your database. So earlier, for connecting MySQL, I explained to you the package which is relevant for MySQL. Now, for connecting Oracle, the package is CX underscore Oracle. You can see the package name here. CX underscore Oracle. So this is the library or a package which is helping you to connect your Python's environment to your database environment. The first step, whenever you have a new package which is not installed so far, go to your command prompt and install the package with the help of your PAP. Pip install the package name. So once you install from the cloud environment or Python third-party environment to your local environment, then you can import that package. So come back to your Python environment and import that package. So import the package name, CX underscore Oracle. Now, once you import the package, since it is database connection, the similar four steps are there. The first one is connection, the second one is cursor, and third one is execute. And in case if you have any commit, you can do the commit, like updations or deletions. So since the first step is the connect, the package name dot the function name in bracket, the username, password, and the location where you have that connection. So cs.oracle.connection in bracket, username, Scott, password, Tiger, and the location. So if it's a local environment in your personal PC, it will be by default localhost. If it's a company environment, there will be a IP address or the location name, host location, which is shared by your administrator. So just mention those things. And since going forward, typing the entire thing will be a lengthy one. So we are going to be stored the entire path in CON. It's a dummy variable name to refer entire length, entire path, the connection path. And to execute the Oracle environment, you can say queries, we are going to use cursor. So con.cursor is going to be created. Once you create this one, the object is going to be created. Object reference ID will be created. With the help of your object reference ID using a cursor, we can able to pass any valid SQL or Oracle statements with the help of cursor only. So con.cursor, I'm going to store this particular object in cursor one. So cursor one dot execute. In while doing the execution, in bracket, I'm going to write my Oracle valid queries. So select star from table name. So this is going to be execute and it is going to be stored in cursor one object. So the results, whatever you have in this Oracle, or the results, whatever you had in your SQL, are stored in your cursor object. So once it's stored in a cursor object, to retrieve the data in Python environment, I'm going to use a for statement. It was stored as an object only, but I want to result row by row. So I'm going to use a for loop for row in cursor one, print row. So each row will be extracted manually and it will be stored. And sorry, it will be print. You can see in the bottom how it's executed. Just to explain you further, fetch the records one by one. I want to fetch the records one by one. You can see here, there is an option called fetch one. It is a function to fetch the records one after one, not at one shot. So when you use select star from table name, system will fetch all the records and store it in cursor. But my intention is I don't want to fetch all the records at once. And by using for loop, I don't want to display it. Is there any other alternative we have? Means there is a function for that. So the connection is similar, no other option. Cursor, you have to do it. Cursor.execute select star from the department. That means this, the data, whatever we have it, it will be stored in cursor. Now, instead of using a for loop, I use fetch one. So cursor.fetch one, I'm going to store it in row. Now print row. Now you can see. The records are displayed one by one instead of using for loop. Fetches the first record by default control will point to the first record. Cursor object fetches the sec stores and first record, later stores the variable row. So what is happening here means wherever you have a control, from there the system is going to fetch the records. It's not meaning that by default every record it will start from this first. For an example, if a cursor is located in third row, then first two records will not be fetched. So there is a limitation in this. So you need to be more cautious, fetch one. Or else better to use for loop. Every record will be there. No, Amar, I want to display only for top five or top 10. Is there an option? Means instead of going fetch one, go with fetch many. So fetch many. So fetch many in bracket five. So when you use fetch many bracket five, system is going to display top five records. Not top five, it's the first five records, I mean to say. It will be displayed. Any questions on this, how it works?
No more.
I want top five records. In a sense, you can use in Oracle, we have ascending order by ascending, order by descending. We have so employee order by salary descending. That means the salary, I want the topmost one in the first position, and the salary which is smallest is in last position. So when you maintain an ascending order or descending order, system automatically sort the data. Since you mentioned five records, system is going to take for top five only by salary. So you got top five only. That way also you can do that. So these functions are applicable for your SQL as well, not only for Oracle. Now, coming back to Python environment, and what we can do means we can able to implement and provide some kind of graphical representation. It's not always giving the numbers on the tables. So we have a package called Matplotlib. Matplotlib is the package which is helping you to give the graphical representation to the management. So you might be extracted. Select star from table name. You got some data. Now you want to give a visualization format, not on summary format. Summary is nothing but table. You don't want to give in table format. You want to give in visualization format. So how can I give means? You can go with Matplotlib. So as I told you, Matplotlib is the first time we are using. So I'm going back to my command prompt and pip install Matplotlib. When you install this one, system automatically install in the required packages. Now you can see here the supported package is also installed. When a package is installing and the supporting packages, which in case if you don't have it, that will be also unpacked and installed. For example, right now NumPy is not there in my environment, so NumPy got installed. So install collected packages NumPy 6 Python date util cycler pipe racing kiwi solver and Matplotlib. Though I installed only one package called Matplotlib, the supporting package, rest of the five got installed automatically. In case if it's not installed, do not worry. The system will highlight you. So once the package is not unpacked, kindly install. So you can install manually by going to pip install the package name, pip install NumPy, pip install 6. In case if it's not installed. Automatically, it's not unpacked. So you can see run. Python, sorry, cd slash. I need to come back to C drive as my Python is here. As I told you, don't go with 3.8 version, go with 3.7 version. 3.8 has some issues, so you cannot able to execute. In case if you execute also, you'll get an error. And go to script environment. In the script environment, you can see PAP. So with the help of this PAP only, we can able to install the packages. So this is located under C drive, Python scripts. So cd Python 37. So now I'm in cd in C drive Python, but I need to enter into scripts. So cd so I'm in scripts. In a scripts, I can able to utilize this package called pip. So pip install matplotlib. It will show that the requirement is satisfied, because while doing this snapshots, I installed it. So I installed it, so that particular package is already installed. So you can see the requirement is already satisfied. In case if it's already installed, it will say that requirement is already satisfied. If it's not installed, you will find up downloading options like this, the snapshot. Hope you are clear what I'm trying to say. And just to make you ensure, I installed under 3.7 version, not on 3.8 version. You can see 3.7. So going forward, I use only 3.7, not 3.8. If I use 3.8, some of my programs can be executed, some of my programs are not going to be executed. So I will be in dynamo whether my program is right or wrong. So I'm using only 3.7, not 3.8. Any questions? So once you install, we can able to create any kind of graph. So now I want to create a graph. So matplotlib module for generating a different type of plots. This plots can be either a pie chart or a bar chart or a histogram or a line graph, anything I can able to create it. So import, once you install in your command prompt, the first step what we need to do is we need to create a plot. We need to import it. So import matplotlib.py plot. So matplotlib is the package name. Matplotlib.py plot is the library package name with function name which I'm using. So matplotlib.py plot is the thing what I need to be call it. Going forward, calling matplotlib.py plot is going to be a lengthy one. So I'm going to use alias name as plt. So instead of calling the matplotlib.py plot, I'm going to use plt. So plt.plot. So once I import this plot related package, I'm going to use plt.plot in bracket. In x axis, I'm going to give 123. In y axis, I'm giving 574. Some random numbers I enter. And if you observe here, that is a list. So within the plot, I have three different numbers and which are in list, x and y axis. Once you give your numbers, then just using plot.show, I want to display the plot. So you can see here the same thing. I have it. Now I'm in 3.7 version, not in 3.8. I just executed, you can see the graph is created. So one is an x-axis and corresponding y is 5. You can see under 5 we have a one dot.
and the next connection is 2 on x-axis and y-axis is going to be 7. And 3 is on x-axis and corresponding y is 4. You can see that the just a basic graph is created. In a Python, we have a provision. We can able to zoom. Where is this reset? Or we can able to move the cursor. Or we can able to change the panel size. We have anything. Whatever you want, you can do that. Then you can save this plot how you want to be save it. Any questions? How to create a graph? A basic graph. Now I want to create two different graphs. Can I able to create means? Yes, we can create it. So my first one has a list of our numbers 1, 2, 3, and my y1 is going to be 574. So my x1 and y1 is into one line, and x2 y2 is another line, and 4 different variables are list only. Now plot dot plot. So assuming that I completed the first step, import matplotlib.py plot as a plt, assuming that is imported, then only I'm doing these 4 steps. So plt.plot in bracket x1.y1. So corresponding x values and corresponding y values are given, and label equal to first line. I'm giving the label as first line, and plt.plot x2, y2, label equal to second line. I just given. Now in a plot we have functionality. We can able to give what is my x variable, what is my y variable, the labels, access names. So plot dot x label, the x axis ka what name you want to give. So x plot dot x label in bracket plot number. So plot number I given. And y axis ka name I want to give import variance, the variance I mentioned. And the entire plot, the graph, I want to give some name. This plot belongs to what? So inserting a graph and slash n, and I enter slash n means I want the subsequent line or subsequent test supposed to be displayed in second line, in the next line. So slash n, check it out. That is the reason. After slash n, the rest of the test is displayed in the next line. Now by seeing this color, I cannot able to predict whether it is going to be first line or a second line. So I want to display the legend. So plot dot legend. When you use plot dot legend, this legend will be displayed. So once you decide this is going to be your plot, and you are going to be show x-axis and y-axis with so and so labels or so and so names, and you have main title as so and so, and you have your own legend, then display plot dot show. System is going to display this plot. Any questions? Or is it clear? Is it confusing?
Normal, but we need to practice, I think.
It's a very simple one, only practice, yes. So bar graph. So import the same functionality. You need to import the matplotlib.py plot as some alias name. Here I'm using plt. You can use anything. So plt.bar. So plt is nothing but matplotlib.py plot. That bar. Earlier I not given anything. I just mentioned plot. So system is taken the corresponding plot. But right now, purposefully, I'm mentioning I want a bar graph. Where is this? My PPT gone. 1 second. Yeah, I want a bar graph to be displayed. So plot dot bar in bracket. I want to create a bar graph based on x and y axis. So on x, so and so location has to be there. On y axis, what is the maximum number you have to be there? So x and y axis I'm giving. In x axis 13579, and on y axis the bar has to be appear up to so and so number. So that means my first bar supposed to be at first location in axis x, and y axis it's supposed to be filled up to 5. So that is the reason you can see 1 to 5. So I given my x and y axis, and the blue colors on the first bar whatever you created, you supposed to be labeled with LG. On second bar, what you have in x and y axis, label with Sony, and color equal to G, nothing but green. So you can see the Sony color is green. And second bar, when I mention, I ensure that that is not overlapped with my first graph. So 2, 4, it's overlapped actually. Type of mistake actually 6, 8, 10. It's a type of mistake while entering, but later I modified while executing. You can see here, it's changed. So I ensure that there's no overlap. And Y graph, Y can be overlapped because Y is nothing but height. But X, I ensure that it's not overlapped. If you, there are some different graphs where it can be overlapped. But right now, I ensure that there is no overlap. So when you are doing the practice, just ensure that this is 6, not a 5. Label Sony color G. So I just ensure that I legend. So plot dot legend. So the legend is going to help me to know this blue color is belongs to what and green color belongs to what. So the legend LG and Sony can be able to get. On x axis, I want to know the bar number, the name of the x axis. On y axis, I want to know the name of the y axis. So plot dot x label, plot dot y label. You can plot height. The height is going to be tell you by this name, and title epic graph another line wow something whatever you want to display within the double or single or triple quotation, and plot dot show you'll come to know. Similarly, histogram, there is a lot of difference between histogram and bar graph. Bar graph generally use it when you have what, discrete numbers. Like how many males are there, how many females you have. When you have discrete numbers, you can go for bar graph. When you have continuous numbers, we prefer to go for histogram. For an example, the BP between 80 to 100 belongs to one category. The BP between 100 to 120, they belong to another category. The BP between 120 to 140, they belong to another category. Similarly, height. All the students whose height is less than 5 belongs to category 1. Between 5 to 5.5 category 2, 5.5 and above category 3. So when you have continuous data, you prefer to go for histogram. When you have discrete data, we prefer to go for bar graph. So histogram. So there is a ages. Though I mentioned here the discrete data, assuming that this is a continuous data range. So there is a different age group of people from 20 to 2, somewhere around 115. 120 is the highest number. So 20 to 120, there is a different age group people are there. Now, if I plot it as a bar, that will be like a spikes. So all 20 people will be there. Each one will have some spike. If I'm asking you how many people are there below 20 or above 20 or the age group of 100, I cannot able to answer it. So to avoid that, what we can do is we'll group the age groups. Based on the age groups, we can do that. So what I'm doing is I'm creating a bins in a list. So 0 to 130 I created. So 0 to 10, one bin, 10 to 20, one bin, 20 to 30, one bin, 30 to 40, another bin, and so on. So each 10 years age group, the gap of 10 years, we made it as one bin. Then now I want to create a histogram. So plot dot histogram in bracket, the age group, the ages, whatever I have it. So the first input, comma. My second input will be that differentiation, nothing but bins. The groups. So there is nothing but bins, comma. History type equal to bar. So the histogram, how you want to be display means I want to create as a bar with this 0.8. So the gap I'm going to be decided. So the gap is 0.8. Now X label I made it as X and Y label I made it as a Y. And the main title I given as interesting graph. Then finally I want to give a legend. But right now there is no legend, so it's not displayed. Plot.show. System is going to display the show, the plot. Is it any questions here? Similarly, you can create one more graph called scatter plot. So scatter plot, generally we can create wherever X and Y values are matches, the intersection point. So 1 and 5, earlier we created bar graph on X axis location 1, on Y axis 5, we created a bar graph here. But right now I don't want to create a bar graph, I want to create a scatter plot, that means the intersection point. So 1 and 5 is going to be here, so that is going to be create. So scatter plot is going to be another type of graph between X and Y axis, wherever it matches the intersection point of X and Y, it will be display a point. So plot.scatter, the first input, first axis and second axis, X and comma Y axis, and within the graph I want to display something, some test. So skit cat, so you can see here skit cat. So the label is created and colors, I want the points what you highlighted, the intersection points I want to display as a green color, and size, and it should be like a marker. So you can see the size is 25 and marker is the round color shape, the dotted one, and X label, Y label, and the title, legend, and show. In case if you have 2-3 scatters, then the legend will be displayed. Any questions? Now this is another graph, stack plot. Stacked one, stacked bar, stacked plot, both are there. We have stacked bar and stacked plot. I want to know in 24 hours how many hours you are spending for sleeping, how many hours you are spending for eating, how many hours you are spending for working and playing. So I want to differentiate it. So for that, what I taken is I have taken days 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 days in a week, from Monday to Friday, and your sleeping hours are here 7, 8, 6, 11, and 7. Eating hours are here 2, 3, 4, 3, 2. Working hours and playing hours. So there are 4 sections you have. When you sum all these 4 sections, it will become as 24 hours only, as we have only 24 hours. Now I want to give the visualization for this. So I'm using a scatter plot. You can use scatter plot or scatter bar. If you use a bar, it will be bar graph and colors will be the same. Or if you use plot, the plot will be look like this. Scatter plot, the first one is going to be days 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, comma, sleeping time, eating time, working time, and playing time. I have four sections, subsections. And each section I want to be differentiated by color. So I'm giving my own colors instead of taking predefined colors. So color equal to this color and 4 colors I mentioned here, and X label equal to X and Y label equal to Y, and title, legend, and show. But unfortunately in a scatter plot, the legend functionality will not work. The legend function whatever you mentioned here will not work in our scatter plot. So how to overcome from this? Since I know the program, I know this color belongs to sleeping, this color belongs to eating, and this color R is going to be working, and K is belongs to playing. Unless until if I see the program, I cannot differentiate which color belongs to which kind of activity. So to get my legend in my stacked plot or stacked blur, there is a piece of code I need to add. That piece of code is nothing but here there are four lines I just added. In the same program, whatever I have it in the previous step, I continued with that, but before giving the scat plot, I just added four more lines. Plot dot plot. I'm passing empty lines, empty list. That means there is nothing to display. Color equal to M. So where I mentioned the M for sleeping. So M label sleeping, line width equal to 5. So I just given empty list for X and Y axis, and I want to display so and so color for sleeping. So it is a customized legend, not given by legend function. So if I use legend function, it will not be displayed. So I created this box as a customized one with the line width I given as a 5. So the width you can see as a 5. And I just mentioned the label to be displayed as sleeping. So it's displaying as sleeping. So it's a customized graph dependent on some situations. When the legend is not working, you can use this functionality. Similarly, pie chart. So pie chart is nothing but plot.py. Now I have import matplotlib.py plot as plot, and I have some data. So slices 7 to 13. So there are some slices I have. Activities. So the same 24 hours only, the activities what I'm doing. So sleeping, eating, working, and playing. So I have different activities for different number of hours. So sleeping maybe 7 hours, eating 2 hours, working 2 hours, and playing 13 hours. Now each one I'm going to be colored. Some different colors I'm giving, red, blue, something. Now by combining these three parts, I want to create a pie chart. So plot.py. Slices is nothing but the data. Label with activities. Activities are nothing but sleeping, eating, working, and playing. Colors with colors. So colors is nothing but here, CMRB colors. Starting from the 90 degrees. So this is totally 360 degrees. I want to start from the 90 degrees. So that from here. And shadow equal to true. So I want shadow to be there or not. You need to decide it for the particular activity. You can see here, when you slice it, you can see there is a shadow, small shadow. And you want the particular activity to be explored or not. Explored in the sense, you can see the piece of cake, working hours. I displayed it. I separated from the piece of cake. The piece has been separated from the entire pie chart. So explore is nothing but which activity you want to be separated. So now how I decided only working hours has to be displayed means you can see 0, 0, 0.2, comma 0. This number can be anything between 0 to 1. So 0, 0, 0.2, 0 is nothing but working is third position. Sleeping, eating, working, and playing. So working is third position. So the third position should be some other number instead of 0. So 0.2 I given. So that is separated by your pie chart. Explore. And once you close and once you give your title and show, system is displaying this graph, the right hand side graph. But I want to display in a percentage. When you want to display as a percentage, how many hours, how many percentage of your time used for working or playing, then you can add this functionality, auto PCT, percentage. Percentage 1.1, F and percentage. If you use this one, the system will convert all these numbers into percentages and display these numbers. Any questions? Yamini and Giri.
No, Amar.
Okay, we'll draw for the day and tomorrow we'll continue. Yeah, thank you.